Let us now invite our first speaker of the day, Mr. Ninad Bedekar. Ninad Gangadhar Bedekar is a historian, writer, and orator from Pune, Maharashtra. He is a prolific contributor to newspapers and magazines. He has scripted The Son of Lumiere show at Shanivar Wada and written the script for Marathi TV serial Peshwai. He is acquainted with the Modi, Persian, and Arabic. He holds a diploma in mechanical engineering. Bedekar is known for his research on the forts of Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, and numerous forts outside India, having led numerous treks to them. He is an honorary member of Fort Renovation and Beautification Committee for the Government of Maharashtra and life member of Bharat Itihas Sanshodak Mandal, Shri Shivaji Raigad Smarak Mandal, Pune. Shri Shivaji Raigad Smarak Mandal, Chairman, Maharashtra Kalopasak, Pune Chairman. He is also an author of various renowned books on forts in India. May I now call upon Mohan Rao to please come up on stage and commence with his presentation. I'm really sorry. Mohan Rao to come up on stage and commence.
Thank you, Samira, for giving me an opportunity to bat first. And I have a responsibility of scoring 264 runs. Good morning, everybody. I'm delighted to be in front of you today to share some thoughts about the water management on medieval forts. Not only medieval, but ancient medieval as well as the modern forts. I know I am the odd man out. I am a forts man. I am not the waterman. But I always kept my eyes open while moving on the forts and watching the water systems and lakes and the systems on the fort. You are all aware that water is going to be the cause of future wars, as we have been watching for the last 4 or 5 years. The rain is unpredictable, it is scanty, sometimes it rains very heavily when it is not required, and when it is required it doesn't rain, then there is a hailstorm. And from Marathwada and other regions, now Vidarbha also, as well as Khandesh, people are migrating to nearby cities. Mumbai is getting almost 10 to 15,000 people every day, new people. They are coming here and residing in. And Pune, of course, we are getting about 3 to 4,000 people every day. Pune's population has gone up to 60 lakhs. From 25 to 60 in last 10 years. There are 4 dams which were catering to the needs of Pune first, but there's some projects like Lavasa which have come up, and now one of the politicians had said that he is going to build another 27 Lavasas. So I don't know what is going to happen. Water resource management, I should not speak because there are a lot of speakers over here who will give. But there are 3 points in this particular presentation. One is what and why. The second point is water resource management on forts. The forts are the ancient forts, the medieval forts, and the modern forts. And the third point which I am going to talk about is the timeless water management techniques, and mainly on the forts. So water resource management, see, we have to store water, we have to conserve water, and we have to distribute it properly. This is called as the culture. The conservation, culture, management, these are the same, these are the different words for the same thing. But culture is the synonym for civilization. As you are all aware, that the civilizations grew on the banks of the rivers, right from Africa, on the banks of Nile, or Tigris and Euphrates, and then of course our own Indus Valley civilization from Sindhu. And in Afghanistan, there is a river called Kabul. So on the banks of Kabul, the civilization grew. Sindhu, then Jhelum, then Chenab, Ravi, Satluj, Bias, Yamuna, and Ganga, Narmada. There are two small rivers over there. One is Gambhir and Parvati. And then, of course, Tapi, Godavari, Krishna, Bhima. I moved from small Kui in Rajasthan to Nagarjun Sagar. It's a huge water reservoir. There is a big difference in these two. So the civilization and water, they are the two sides of the same coin. Man has almost 90% of water in his body. If it falls below 50%, he will die. So water is required. Water is jivan. Actually, I was for some time the chairperson of Jala Sanskriti Mandal, Pune branch. And during that period of 5 to 6 years, we constructed small bandharas or dams in Mulshi and Pauna and Pavan Mahal. Those people who were cutting forests, were cutting trees and making coal, we brought them together, we enlightened them, we gave them the material, the sands and the cement and everything, and asked them to build small bandharas at proper places around their villages. And now those villages are self-reliant. They don't have to depend upon the rain. Their crops are growing and the problems are reduced. So water is the eternal source, I may call it, of man's internal as well as the external personality, since the body contains water. We need water for drinking, to quench our thirst. Every now and then, we need water. So the challenges during last 30, 40 years are great and need to study for the water culture is essential. Natural calamities, uncertainty of rain, that I said unpredictable rains. Natural disasters, we do not have volcano eruptions, but we have cyclones. And I had experienced that during 77, when I was at Kolar Goldfields, two cyclones within a span of a week, they struck Andhra, Guntur, East Godavari, Krishna. They were wiped out with these two. Almost 1 lakh people died. And we had our engines over there at Sriharikota, and my boss had asked me to go and check up those engines. I just couldn't go there because there was an epidemic after that. They had not predicted the effects of the cyclone. Now, of course, weathermen, they say, but as we were discussing right now, whatever they say, it is something like Sharad Pawar. That whatever he says, he doesn't do that. So the weathermen also, whatever they forecast, so we must ignore. Because 3-4 days back, Pune, they had predicted that there will be rain with thunderstorms in next 48 hours. It doesn't rain. It didn't rain. Only yesterday we got the rain, right? Yesterday evening. Till today, till we left today in the morning, it was raining quite heavily in Pune. Tsunami, I had seen the two different views of tsunami. In Andaman, I had gone before tsunami and 1 year after tsunami. The salt water had not gone out. So the soil is spoiled completely over there. So these are the after effects of tsunami or cyclones. I had seen water spouts over there. Those were not the tornadoes, but water spouts. And I just asked one waiter, क्या है साहब वो बोला साहब बादल पानी पी रहे हैं वो वहाँ का सो बट देर वर वाटर स्पाउट्स इन अंडमान नाउ मैन मेड कैलामिटीज चेंजेस इन क्लाइमेट आई हैव पुट इट इन द मैन मेड कैलामिटीज बिकॉज मैन इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द चेंजेस इन द क्लाइमेट वन इज द पॉपुलेशन एक्सप्लोजन वी हैड वन स्लोगन 40 कोट नहीं दबेंगे अगेंस्ट ब्रिटिशर्स It has gone up to 125 crores, the population of India. And every day it is increasing from Bangladesh and Ceylon. And since Maldives, those islands are going to drown, that population is going to come to Lanka as well as in Tamil Nadu and Kerala. Shrinking of water storage areas, the unlimited drawal of water. Dr. Kulkarni will give you proper ideas of the groundwater, people, they made money on bore wells. At Trichinukodu itself, just one village in Tamil Nadu, how many trucks were registered? I will give you just one glimpse at that. There were 10,000 trucks were registered for bore wells in just one village in Tamil Nadu, like Trichinukodu. So politicians made money on those bores. I think even Lata Mangeshkar also had a partnership with Raj Singh Dungarpur, and they had, drilled some holes in Madhya Pradesh. But we couldn't get the water over there. But I will narrate one example. In 78, the ISRO, with the help of University Grand Commission, they drilled 150 bores. According to the Brihat Samhita, which was written by Varahamihir in the 6th century, Varahamihir, he gives a description depending upon the soil, soil color, the growth on that soil, weeds, then ant hills, termite hills. And he predicts the water sources. So they drilled, and without exception, they got water in 150 wells. Unlimited drawal of water from those. And the level beneath the surface is going down. Soil erosion is another thing. Negligence by the politicians is a big thing. I think I need not explain it what happened at Gosekhurd in Vidarbha, that one of the politicians, after seeing those dried dams, he just said that. Anyway, changes in climate, but we are all responsible for that. That's what I feel. My friend has made one table red soil, that water is having a sweet taste. The brown soil, it has got the acidic taste. The gray soil, it's a saline taste. The blue soil, it's a bitter taste. Yellow soil is a pungent taste. And white soil is an astringent taste. Water resource management, I will switch over to the second point, water resource management on forts. As ancient, medieval, and modern, I have considered up to 1000 AD, it is ancient. 1000 to 1800 AD is medieval, and 1800 onwards are the modern forts. Modern forts are seldom. There are very few forts which are built. But the medieval Satavahan was the dynasty which was known in Maharashtra, which ruled Maharashtra almost 500 years, 250 before Christ and just 250 after Christ. Satavahan, during their era, one king called Hal Satavahan, who collected 700 gathas or gaha satsai, recesses, 700. Out of those 700 recesses, 700 gathas, 450 gathas are related to water. So the importance of water was known to the Satavahana. I'm going to show you one small system. It looks very small from top, but which is very deep inside. Rashtrakut dynasty, which is known for carving caves, and Dantidurga, who was the founder of that dynasty, he of course started Verul caves, but at the same time he started constructing fort at Devagiri. But the credit went to Yadav, Singham Yadav, or Krishna Yadav, or Govind. But there's so many forts were built in the medieval era. There are ground forts, there are hill forts, there are island forts, there are coastal forts.